Welcome to EMTB Videos.
The Mustache Game 29 is a new bike for 2020. Like many others, it has been redesigned to accommodate the new Bosch Performance CX motor. This is a well-built bike. The 625 watt-hours battery sits firmly in the down tube, and it's really easy installing and removing. The cable routing is nice and tidy. It's not making much noise on the descents. The Game 4 feels like a solid and well-built bike. Several French and German brands, such as Mustache, have always had pretty tall and compact frames. The jump tray of the new Game is looking modern, but it's still not among the lowest, longest and slackest. The wheelbase of 1236 mm for a size large is an average length today. The Mustache has got 460 mm chainstays. I'd say that's normal too, although 5 mm longer than most of its competition. So the rear center is slightly longer, making the front center slightly shorter. The consequence of this is that the Mustache Game has a fairly low reach measurement of 448 mm. The tall 635 mm stack height compensates a bit. So does the seat angle of 74 degrees, which is on the slack side these days. The result is that when you sit on the bike, it doesn't feel as short as the reach figure leads us to believe. But once you stand up, you may feel that the reach isn't among the longest. So the heritage of compact frames isn't completely gone. And that's a good thing. All bikes can't be the longest and lowest. The Mustache Game 4 is a comfortable bike to ride. The riding position is relaxing. Unless you have the seat all the way back on the rails, the bike climbs with ease. The chainstays helps push the rider weight forwards, which is a good thing in the steep ups. The 12-speed SRAM SX drivetrain provides lots of low gears to get up pretty much anything. And the 356mm tall bottom bracket provides good ground clearance when pedaling over rock gardens. I've ridden an older Mustache trail before. What stood out was the rear suspension performance. And it's the same this time. The shock doesn't look like much. No fancy piggyback reservoir, just a black and anonymous shock with the words "Just" and "Mustache" printed on it. I never expect much when seeing unfamiliar suspension components. But the Mustache shock is a great performer. The shock along with the rear linkage provides a stable platform that pedals very well. It feels firm while at the same time being active and leveling out the surface. And it feels composed when pedaling hard. I haven't found much info on the suspension kinematics, but it seems it's got a good amount of anti-squat. Not too much though. Just once I felt the rear wheel seize up a bit when pedaling at some speed over a huge obstacle. When descending over rooty sections, it felt so composed and controlled. I think it's cool that the cheaper Game 4 gets the same rear suspension performance as the top of the line Game 10. But it's not getting the same front suspension performance. Of course. The Game 4 has the RockShox 35 Gold RL. This is a pretty basic fork, but it's solid and will take quite some beating. And it's the obvious choice for an entry-level bike such as this. Along with the 65.7 degrees head angle and the powerful Shimano MT-520 four-pot brakes, this makes for a confident bike on the steep trails. We were descending hard on the Mustache, setting fast times, enjoying the rear suspension performance. But it's not the most playful descender. The slightly forward position of the rider and the big battery makes the Game a tad front heavy. It's a stable bike that straight lines some real chunky stuff, but it takes some effort maneuvering the bike in tight sections or when lifting the front. If you value a more relaxed bike, the Game 4 is a great option. It's a capable bike in most sorts of terrain.